Now that you've got your wants versus needs list in hand, the fun really begins. It's time to talk about narrowing down those listings and deciding which ones to see in person. First up, let's talk about best practices for searching online. No doubt you know the sites, Realtor.com, Zillow, Redfin, Trulia, but how can you get the results you want? A few tips I have for you is use the search filters, but not too much. You don't want to restrict your search so tightly that you only have a handful of homes to view. Keeping your wants versus needs list in mind, expand your geographic search and add 25 to 50,000 to your max price, since homes often sell under asking. Also, if you find something that catches your eye, check out the Google Street View. Online pictures can be deceiving, so a virtual walk down the street will give you a better sense of the house and surrounding areas. Another tip is don't shy away from a home because it says pending or under contract. Pending contracts do fall through, so keep it on your list, especially if it checks all of your boxes. After you've found a few homes you like, jot down the MLS number and address. Shoot the list over to me and let me call the listing agent to gather all the information that we need, the seller's disclosure, and gauge the seller's motivation. At this point, it's time to look at the calendar and find a chunk of time to tour the homes on your short list. Carve out more time than you think you'll need, since you don't want to be rushed when you're out of the property if you find a home that may be the one. Have you been searching online for your next home? Find something you keep going back to, send me a message, and let's go have a look.